Let's get your images now of the massive protests that were reported across several top U.S. university campuses over Israel's war with Gaza intensifying. Police were seen cracking down on many of the protesters and arresting several of them. The stir that was so far focused at Columbia University has now spread to at least 5 universities, including Ivy League schools like Harvard and Yale. As many as 34 students were arrested at the University of Texas's Austin campus after 100 state troopers and some locals arrived at the scene. Similar scenes also unfolded at the University of Southern California as police arrested a Palestinian student organizer, with videos showing cops bringing out their batons to take control of the situation. At Harvard, pro-Palestinian protesters stormed the campus to set up encampments. Days after the university restricted access to the yard, the oldest campus, to only Harvard ID holders. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu called the U.S. university's pro-Palestine protests as horrific and said more has to be done to stop them. He accused anti-Semitic mobs of taking over leading American universities and called for the protests to be condemned unequivocally. Let's bring in on this broadcast Gaurav Sawant as well. Gaurav, unprecedented scenes really at U.S. universities, many of them completely shutting down due to these kind of protests, these agitations happening.
There's chaos from coast to coast in the United States of America, from the Columbia University in New York to the University of Southern California and, of course, the University of Texas, Austin. Now you have security forces, whether it's the police, there is threat of the National Guard being deployed. There are state troopers who've been called in. Several students have been detained, some in Columbia, some at Texas, at the University of South California. Again, a large number of protesters were detained by the security forces. And the other aspect here is that there are leaders who are now saying that stop federal funding to these universities if protests continue. The protesters, on the other hand, are demanding an uninterrupted right to protest without punishment. They also want that any company in Israel that's funding these universities, in case they're involved in this war in Gaza, that funding must stop. So major chaos. There's an attempt to find middle ground. Negotiations are taking place so that the encampment can be removed in some places. In some places where encampments have been removed, they're not permitting it to come once again. But the apprehension and the fear is that this fire could spread to other university campuses. On the other hand, scholars are very worried. Some of the students are very worried that in some places, right now they've said that the classes will only be online till the end of the session. The apprehension is if funding to some of these universities is curbed, Israel and the Jewish lobby funds a lot of these universities, if that funding comes to a stop, then there could be more trouble for students and for education. At the same time, there are Palestinian student organizations, and some people are also keeping a close eye on their activities on campus.
You know, unbelievable that these are the kind of images where you've got police officers actually going into campus, arresting students. You've got all-out violence playing out. And these are some of your top universities in America that are witnessing these kind of scenes, where peaceful protests have quickly turned violent. Thanks very much, Gaurav, for joining us.